Good morning. That looks like a lot of work.
Good morning. How are you doing?
I'm well, and you?
I'm all right.
And where are we off to?
We're going to Mumba.
We just went through our first lock. This is a lot of fun. Some of the people on the barge canal cruise decided to walk. There is a path. You can follow along. You can ride a bike. I might do that later on. Well, I finally got off the Belle Epoque. I'm going to go on the path that goes beside the boat in the canal. I'm going to do a little bit of walking today.
Our first village to visit was Falvigny-sur-Ozerain, a very picturesque little village in the heart of the Burgundy region of France. It's where the movie Chocolat was filmed. They've never had a chocolate shop, but it is famous for another type of candy. The town was built around a Benedictine abbey in 719, and part of that abbey is now used as a factory to produce anise pastille, those tasty little hard candies.
Romans built this bridge 2,000 years ago, and it's still here. I think we need to hire them for our highways.
The Fontenay Abbey in Burgundy was founded in 1118 by Saint Bernard of Clairvaux, a leading French saint, and it's the oldest preserved Cistercian abbey in the world. Recognized as a French historic monument in 1862, it was declared a World Heritage Site by UNESCO in 1981, one of the first French monuments on this list. After the French Revolution, which led to the departure of the monks, it was converted to a paper mill, which preserved all the buildings. Located in northern Burgundy, it's nestled in a 1,200-hectare valley which was mostly marshland. But the Cistercians were masters at irrigation, digging lakes and canals to drain the land and provide enough water for the fish that they both ate and sold. Bernard de Clairvaux, who restricted decorations, believed that only light should enter the church. That was from the Byzantine idea that light is God, and that's the only way to experience God's through light. For a long time, it was also believed that perfect proportions can be achieved through music. So when designing the glass windows, numerical ratios corresponding to music were applied. For instance, the seven windows in the west of the interior were distributed according to the musical ratio of three-quarter time. Cistercian abbeys were similar to those of the Benedictines, possessing a dormitory for sleep, a cloister for strolling, a chapter house for the monks' morning meetings, and a caldarium, or warming room, where the monks could read and transcribe. Fontenay today is remarkably well preserved. The gatehouse was restored in the 17th century. Repairs have also been made to the roof. The abbey still possesses its medieval forge with its tremendous hydraulic hammer. The forge was an important producer of iron tools and building components in its day. Other areas to visit include the medicinal gardens and the lakes and water systems. Like so many abbeys, Fontenay was seized during the French Revolution and ceased to function as a religious center. The property was auctioned off and became a paper mill in 1791. Later, it was adopted for other industrial purposes until it was purchased by Edouard Enyard, who restored its structures to their original purity. It remains in the Enyard family and is open to the public. More than 100,000 people visit Fontenay each year to admire its serene beauty. Fontenay Abbey is just another amazing destination on European Waterways Burgundy Canal Tour.